हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू प्रूव ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटी बाय जियोमेट्रिकल मेथड। दैट मीन्स हाउ टू डिराइव द आर आइडेंटिटी। वी हैव थ्री बेसिकली आइडेंटिटी, साइन स्क्वायर ए प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू वन, सेकेंड इज वन प्लस टेन स्क्वायर ए इक्वल्स टू सेक स्क्वायर ए, एंड थर्ड इज वन प्लस कॉट स्क्वायर ए इक्वल्स टू कॉसेक स्क्वायर ए। सो वी कैन प्रूव ऑल दिस बाय द geometry. So first let us draw a triangle, right angle triangle. So triangle ABC is a right angle, right angle at a B. So according to this we are considering this angle A. So whether we can, so by the angle A or we can assume theta, both will be same. Now opposite to angle B is hypotenuse, that is ACs are hypotenuse, and for angle A BC is a perpendicular and this is the base side. So in a right triangle ABC, right angle at in a triangle ABC, right angle at B, we have by Pythagoras theorem. So AB square plus BC square equals to AC square by the PGT theorem. Let this is equation one. For each identity, we have to show up to here first assumptions and apply the by PGT in your triangle, right angle triangle. Then let by PGT equation first. Now here we are going to divide sine square a plus cos square a equals to 1. So for this triangle, what is the sine a? Sine a, that is P by H, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So it is the BC upon AC. And for the cos a, that is base upon hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC. So first we will divide by the hypotenuse square. So divide both side of equation 1 by the AC square we get. So we can write AB square upon AC square. So we can write in same square, same bracket, AB upon AC square plus BC upon AC square equals to AC square upon AC square. So this will cancel out. So AB upon AC, according to this value for this triangle, AB upon AC, we can write cos A. So cos A square. And similarly for sin A, that is BC upon AC. So sin A whole square equals to 1 square. And this can be written cos square A plus sin square A equals to 1. So our first identity proved. Now for the second identity, we will prove up to here same. And now we will divide by the AB square. So for second identity, now divide both sides of equation 1 by AB square we get. AB square for the second identity are requirement tan and sec. So we can write for the value of tan A and sec A from this triangle ABC. So what is tan? P by B, that is perpendicular upon base. So which is equals to BC upon AB for this triangle, and sec A, that is AC upon AB. Now we are going to divide equation 1, that is AB square plus BC square equals to AC square by the AB square. So AB square upon AB square, BC square BC upon AB whole square, and AC upon AB whole square. That is, we can write for the same value in one bracket. So AB, AB will cancel out. We have a 1 square BC upon AB. So here is a BC upon AB, that is tan A. So tan A whole square, and AC upon AB, that is sec A. So we can write sec A whole square. This means this 1 square 1, tan A whole square can be written tan square A, and sec A whole square can be written sec square A. So this is our second identity, 1 plus tan square A equals to sec square A. Now again, for the third identity, our requirement is cot square A and sec A. So we can write cot A value for this triangle ABC. So cot A is AB upon BC, and cos A, that is opposite to sin, that is AC upon BC. Now we will divide both side of equation 1 by BC square. So we will get AB upon BC whole square plus BC upon BC whole square plus AB upon AC upon BC whole square. So AB upon BC, that is cot A. So we can write cot A whole square plus this will cancel out. So 1 whole square, and this is AC upon BC, that is cosec A whole square, which can be written cot square A plus 1 equals to cosec square A. So this is our trigonometric identity, and this is proved by the geometrical method also.